The girl, named Chloe, made a horrifying discovery while taking her medication. After 18 years of using the same pill bottle, she found another label hidden behind it. Rather than raising alarm, the clever girl pretended ignorance and continued taking the medication her mother brought her. Once her mother turned away, she discreetly spat it out, staring at the blue pill in her hand with a mix of fear and confusion. What had she been taking all these years? Determined to uncover the truth, she sneaked into the living room while her mother slept, booted up the computer, and entered the code from the pill bottle, hitting enter. Chloe eagerly glanced at the screen, only for the computer to suddenly lose its internet connection, displaying only the words Digoxin 3. Disappointed, Chloe sighed. Unbeknownst to her, there were eyes watching her intently from the kitchen. Chloe, a single-parent girl, had suffered from asthma, paralysis, and various illnesses since childhood. Despite her daily struggles, her mother never complained, tirelessly providing rehabilitation training for her daughter year after year. Just when Chloe thought things were looking up for her future, an accident occurred on her 18th birthday. Seizing the moment while her mother was out buying a birthday cake, Chloe sneaked into the kitchen to grab a few pieces of chocolate. As she was leaving, Chloe accidentally stumbled upon a bottle of the blue pills she had been taking for over a decade. Oddly enough, the label on the prescription wasn't in Chloe's name, but her mother's. Chloe knew the serious consequences of taking prescription medication improperly. She promptly reported the discovery to her mother, expecting concern. However, to Chloe's surprise, her mother remained calm, dismissing it as a mistake and insisting that the pharmacy couldn't possibly have made an error. Then, her mother scolded Chloe for sneaking chocolates in her absence, warning her about the potential harm to her teeth if she overindulged. Seeing her mother's apparent concern, Chloe began to doubt her own suspicions, thinking maybe she had just misread the label after all. The next day, Chloe couldn't shake the feeling that something was off about the blue pill she held in her hand. So, she quietly slipped into her mother's room to confirm her suspicions. Carefully using a mechanical arm, she reached up to the cabinet and retrieved the pill bottle, examining it closely in her hand. Before long, she noticed a bubble under the label on the bottle, indicating it had been resealed. Chloe attempted to peel it off with her fingers and, sure enough, discovered another label hidden underneath. Recalling the previous incident, she pretended ignorance, swallowing the blue pill in front of her mother and discreetly spitting it out when her mother left. Using the internet before the connection was lost, Chloe learned that the blue capsules were called Tacoxin, but their exact effects remained unclear. Unbeknownst to Chloe, her mother was secretly watching her from the kitchen. Clearly, there was some undisclosed secret between them. The next day, while her mother was eating, she casually mentioned that the computer seemed to be offline and asked Chloe if she knew anything about it. But Chloe wasn't naive. She knew her mother was trying to subtly lead her into talking about what happened last night with the pill bottle. So, she explained that she had fallen asleep after taking the pills her mother had brought her, and as for the computer being offline, she had no idea. Both of them played dumb, each knowing the other's intentions, and her mother didn't press further. After lunch, Chloe noticed her mother outside in the yard watering the flowers, realizing she might be occupied for a while. Seizing the opportunity, she quickly made her way to the phone and dialed the number for the pharmacy. Strangely, before Chloe could even finish speaking, the clerk on the other end immediately mentioned Chloe's mother's name, indicating they were in cahoots. Watching her mother watering the flowers outside, Chloe decided to give it another shot. This time, she randomly dialed a stranger's number, fortunate that the person happened to be near their computer. Following Chloe's instructions, he searched online for the effects of Digoxin. The results revealed that it's a medication used to treat congenital heart disease. Chloe's anxieties were finally eased, realizing she had been overly worried. Just as she was about to hang up the phone, the man on the other end mentioned something odd. He said the pills were always red. Chloe froze in disbelief. She never imagined her mother would tamper with the pills. After all, she was her own daughter. During dinner that evening, Chloe didn't expose her mother's conspiracy. Instead, she pretended to be unaware and casually mentioned that she hadn't been to the movies in a while and would like to go. Her mother agreed to her daughter's request. The next day, Chloe gathered all the blue pills she had accumulated over the past few days. Then, halfway through the movie, she feigned feeling unwell and left the theater, clutching the pills. Before her mother could notice, Chloe quickly made her way to a pharmacy. However, upon arrival, she was stunned to see dozens of customers waiting in line. If she waited her turn at this pace, her mother would surely notice. So, Chloe politely asked everyone to let her cut in line. When she finally reached the pharmacist, Chloe pulled out the blue pills from her pocket and asked what they were. the pharmacist, upon seeing the pills, was astonished. They turned out to be medication used to alleviate leg pain in pets. If ingested by a human, it would cause temporary paralysis in the legs. Shocked by the revelation, Chloe realized she wasn't born with congenital paralysis. It was caused by the blue pills her mother had been giving her. Just then, her mother walked in. Pretending to be concerned, she knelt before Chloe and discreetly injected a sedative into her thigh. Chloe tried to cry out for help, but no sound came out. Soon after, she collapsed into the wheelchair, unconscious. Once the effects of the medication wore off, Chloe woke up from her unconscious state. Glancing around, she noticed her mother had already taken her back to the bedroom, with food prepared on the bedside table. Chloe had no intention of staying here any longer. She approached the door, tried the handle, only to find that her mother had already locked it from the outside. After shouting for what seemed like an eternity with no response, Chloe fashioned a makeshift lockpicking tool using two hairpins and managed to unlock the door. But her mother had another trick up her sleeve. Seeing this method fail, Chloe turned her attention to the nearby window. Before taking action, she connected a piece of electrical wire to a power source and took a large gulp of ice-cold water, making sure to keep it in her mouth without swallowing. With everything set, Chloe dragged her paralyzed legs and crawled out of the window, moving forward step by step. After relentless efforts, she finally crawled to her mother's window and gave it a push. To her surprise, her mother had anticipated her attempt to climb out and had locked the window from the outside before leaving. But that didn't stop Chloe at all. She connected the electrical wire to a power source and used the hot end to pierce the glass. After a few minutes, the glass cracked under the heat, and Chloe promptly spat the ice water from her mouth onto the glass. With the thermal expansion and contraction, Chloe successfully broke open the window and crawled into the bedroom. She glanced at the telephone not far away, only to find that the wire had been cut. All that effort for nothing. Sitting in the wheelchair, she made her way to the staircase, intending to escape. But the power line had also been cut. With no other options, Chloe simply pushed the wheelchair down the stairs, taking a deep breath and following it down. The pain radiating from her limbs was excruciating, but Chloe couldn't help but smile. Her paralyzed legs, dormant for years, were unexpectedly regaining sensation. With newfound hope, Chloe mustered all her strength and flagged down a freight truck by the roadside. Fortunately, the driver reacted quickly and stopped just in time, saving Chloe's life. The man often delivered goods in this area and recognized her at a glance. Upon learning that Chloe had been imprisoned by her mother, he decided to take her to the police station to report the incident. Just then, Chloe's mother arrived in her car, and the three collided head-on. Claiming that her daughter had some mental issues and might speak nonsense, the mother insisted on taking her back home for treatment. She threatened to call the police if they intervened. When the man refused to back down, the mother injected him with a vial of medication, rendering him incapacitated. Chloe found herself once again at the mercy of the deranged woman. To prevent her from escaping again, the mother locked her in the basement. As Chloe circled the room, she stumbled upon a file folder in a trash bin, containing the acceptance letter she had longed for. It turned out that she had been accepted to her dream university 2 years ago. To prevent her from escaping, her mother had hidden the acceptance letter. Nearby, a file box caught Chloe's attention. Upon inspection, she found that her wheelchair was chained to it. Undeterred, Chloe crawled forward and opened the box. Inside were a pile of children's photos. Could these be Chloe's childhood pictures? She uncovered a note on top, and what she saw shocked her. Her mother had told her that her legs were congenitally disabled, that she was born this way. But the lively children in the photos showed no signs of disability. What shook Chloe to the core was finding her birth certificate underneath, stating that she had passed away less than 2 hours after birth. Yet here she was, alive and well. It finally dawned on Chloe. So, Chloe realized that the woman upstairs wasn't her real mother. Unable to cope with the loss of her own child at the hospital, she had taken someone else's baby as her own. As the child grew up, to prevent her from being discovered by her biological mother, the woman resorted to drugging Chloe and keeping her perpetually imprisoned. Seeing her daughter uncover the truth from years ago, the woman decided to disable Chloe's legs and imprison her permanently in the basement. She had lost her sanity, indistinguishable from a madwoman. In her attempt to escape, Chloe stumbled upon a warehouse behind her and quickly darted inside, shutting the door behind her. With her mother on the verge of breaking in, Chloe found herself in a desperate situation. She noticed a bottle of weed killer on a shelf and took a gamble, reckoning that her mother wouldn't allow her to die so easily. Just before her mother broke through the door, Chloe swallowed the poison. Fortunately, Chloe's gamble paid off. Her mother rushed her to the hospital for emergency treatment. Although Chloe was saved, there were still traces of poison in her system, requiring further observation. Her mother stood outside, watching her intently. Chloe tried to call for help, but she couldn't make a sound. With all her strength, she managed to activate the alarm button beside her. A nurse hurried to Chloe's side, asking how she could assist. Seeing Chloe repeatedly pointing to the marker pen in her pocket, the nurse understood her intention and fetched a notebook for her to write on. Just as Chloe was halfway through writing, the alarm suddenly went off behind her, and the nurse rushed out. Moments later, Chloe's mother burst into the room, clearly responsible for the alarm. She distracted the nurse and then whisked Chloe away from the ward. As they maneuvered through the corridors, Chloe deliberately exposed the restraint band on her arm, but nobody paid attention. They were close to escaping the hospital when the nurse from earlier returned to find Chloe missing. Upon seeing the words written in the notebook, she immediately realized the danger and urgently called for security to intercept them. Luckily, their quick response prevented Chloe's mother from succeeding, and Chloe was successfully rescued. In the days that followed, Chloe gradually regained her ability to stand through rehabilitation training. The woman who posed as her mother was confined to a mental institution. In the final scene, Chloe visited the ward under the guise of a visitor. With a smile on her face, she recounted to the woman who claimed to be her mother how wonderful it felt to be free. However, the woman across from her was trembling in fear at Chloe's smile. Then, with practiced ease, Chloe spat out three blue pills from her mouth.
I love you, Mom.